Researchers at University of California, Davis recently reported that they were able to dramatically reduce the number of antibiotic-resistant germs in breastfed newborns' intestines. Well, how? By giving the babies probiotics for just 3 weeks during their first month of life. Baby gut health for the win! Pediatrician Dr. Tanya Altmann joins us to weigh in. And you know, Dr. Altmann, that I'm a big believer in gut health and, yes. and the good gut bacteria. This is, to my knowledge, the first study of its kind when it comes to babies. This is remarkable.
Well, UC Davis has been doing a lot of research on the newborn gut microbiome, and they've actually identified the one specific bacteria. It's called B. infantis, and this is the one good gut bacteria you want to help program the baby's immune systems early on in life. And when you don't have the specific good gut bacteria, then you get the overgrowth of the bad, unhealthy gut bacteria. And that's what's linked to conditions later on in life, mm-hmm. such as like eczema and allergies and colic and obesity. So gut health is really important for the babies. And at UC Davis, they were able to feed the babies this B. infantis probiotic every day, and they were actually able to show that it decreased the bad gut bacteria by 80%. And that's really huge.
And so you're basically taking a baby who you don't know what their gut profile is, and you're saying, you're introducing all these good gut bacteria yeah. to help kind of push out the potential bad players, because not all bacteria are good, but the great majority of them actually do good things for us.
They do, but the thing is that due to generations of medical interventions such as C-sections and antibiotic use, which can be life-saving, we've actually decreased mm-hmm. the good gut bacteria in moms to pass on to babies. So the majority of babies born now don't have this specific B. infantis bacteria that the data shows to be so important.
When do you think this might be put into practice more broadly, A? The B question is, what can parents do for their kids' gut microbiome who have already gone through the first few months of life? Maybe they're 1, 2, 3 years of age.
Sure, so this actually is a product that you can use. It's called Evivo B. infantis, and you can supplement little babies starting soon after birth for the first few months of life or even longer. And they were actually able to show that even a few months can really colonize the baby's gut with this high levels of the good gut bacteria. And then once kids get older and they start eating, you want, as you always talk about, a variety of healthy foods, mm-hmm. a high fiber diet to help feed that good mm-hmm. gut bacteria.
And I'm not specifically speaking about this study, but just in general, sometimes patients will come in and ask about something called vaginal seeding. With vaginal seeding, basically we take a gauze and then we will get some of mom's vaginal fluid, and then they will put the bacteria or that fluid on baby's skin, mouth, or nose. At this point, we don't have clinical proof to say that that is safe and or effective. The thought is, okay, well, if I'm gonna have a C-section and I do this vaginal seeding, then I will be able to get my baby exposed to some of that bacteria, and then we'll happen to help out with the gut health, mm-hmm. and as a result, there will be a lower probability of asthma or immune disorders. But once again, at this point, we don't have proof saying that that is safe and or effective. So if you have a C-section, vaginal seeding is not recommended at this time.
You're right, and what's interesting is the B. infantis, the bifidobacteria, is actually a gut bacteria. So you get it by having a delivery and, you know, having a messy delivery, pooping on the delivery table. I mean, it's not actually a vaginal flora that programs the baby's immune system early on in life.
And I know you believe in this too. It's okay to let your kids, unless your doctor says otherwise, to play with pets and go ahead and play outside, because those bacteria that live on your pets and yeah. are in the garden, that's good for
that
us.
That boosts your immune system. Yeah. You're less likely to have allergies to these things later on.
Yeah, and if you're exposed to them early on.
Thanks, Dr. Altmann.